Historians, it's Miss Melton here to talk to you about the Compromise of 1877. In 1877, the federal government withdrew the last federal troops from the South. White Southern Democrats regained power in the state governments. Now, this is from the Scott Forstmann. The top one was from the Pearson text. By 1870, all of the former Confederate states had met all the requirements of Reconstruction and were readmitted to the Union. In 1877, the remaining federal troops were withdrawn from the South. White Southern Democrats regained their power in state governments. Almost immediately, new laws were passed that again restricted the rights of African Americans. So, remember, we had already had the Black Codes, which restricted voting of African Americans, and then the and then the 15th Amendment said you could not restrict voting based on color. So, race or color. So, the Southern Democrats regaining control of Southern state governments decided to make new laws that didn't say it was based on your skin color, but they found other ways to restrict African Americans from voting and having equal rights. So, the things to remember about the Compromise of 1877. It was a result of the election of 1876. At the end of the election, Hayes became the Republican president, and federal troops were withdrawn from the South. So, that was the agreement because it was so close. The Southern Democrats said, we'll let Hayes be the president if you allow federal troops to leave the South. And because the federal troops left, Southern Democrats regained control of the South and continued the Black Codes and made new laws. So that is a little bit about the Compromise of 1877.